We're going to start a series here, which I call Basic Prayer. It's for people that have not had a lot of prayer experience or have not read a lot of books on prayer. There'll be three sections, and each section will have three parts. The first section here, we're calling Why Pray? And that's a good question. Why should we even pray? Well, the first thing we want to look at is from the Word of God, and it's in Psalms 116, verses 1 and 2. The Word of God says, I love the Lord because he hears my voice. That's important. And my prayers for mercy. God hears my voice, and he hears my prayers. Verse 2, I just love this. Because he bends down to listen, I will pray as long as I have breath. So if you've been wondering, why should I pray? Prayer is so important to God that when we begin to just share with him, open our hearts up, share our burdens, and so on, God bends down to listen to everything we say. That shows the importance of prayer to God the Father. It's very important to him that we share our hearts with him, share our situation, share our friends, share our family, or whatever. So why do we pray? Because prayer is extremely important to God. The second thing that we want to look at in prayer is found in Matthew 6. Matthew 6, we have the Lord Jesus talking about prayer. So we see prayer is important to God the Father. And now we see a prayer, what Jesus said about prayer. And I want to read this to you. And it's Matthew 6, verses 5-8. Jesus said, when you pray, don't be like the hypocrites who love to pray publicly on the street corners or in the synagogues where everyone can see them. I tell you the truth, that is all the reward they'll ever get. But when you pray, go away by yourself, shut the door, behind you, and pray to your Father in private. And when your Father sees everything, the Father who sees everything will reward you. When you pray, don't babble on as people of other religions do. They think their prayers are answered merely by repeating their words again and again. Don't be like them, for your Heavenly Father knows exactly what you need even before you ask him. So it is interesting. Jesus didn't say to his followers, if you pray. Jesus said, when you pray. So Jesus expected his followers to pray. So it's very important that we understand that God the Father listens and bends down to hear every word that we say when we pray. And Jesus, to his followers, said again and again and again, when you pray, he expected you to pray. And then he says something that is important. I've been in prayer services where some of the people praying use strange voices. They change their voice, like, oh, and God, and they go on and on, moaning and whatever. And that really calls attention to the person who is praying. And that's, God says, don't do that. He says, go off by yourself and shut the door. Why should we shut the door when we pray? Now, I believe he's saying we shut the door to shut out distractions. So maybe you have, I used to call it a prayer closet or a prayer room or a special place to pray. Mrs. Wesley, the mother of John and Charles Wesley, would sit in a chair and she would take her apron and put it over her head. And her children knew that they needed to be quiet because Mom was talking to God. Another situation that I remember was a wonderful book called 30 Years with the Cannibals. And the young man who became a very wonderful missionary named John, his father had that large room in their house, and that room is where they made socks. So the children were taught or homeschooled way back in the 1800s. But when the dad prayed, he would go into a little alcove that had like a sheet or some type of a material hanging, and he'd pull it across, and the family knew that dad was in there praying to God, and they would work as quietly and be as quiet as possible. Because to develop a prayer life, you'd be amazed at all the distractions that will come. We have an enemy, and the enemy doesn't want me to pray. And all kinds of things can happen to get me to stop or not go to my place of prayer, to spend that time with God. But Jesus said, if possible, he said, go by yourself and shut the door. Isabel Kuhn, who was a wonderful missionary to China under the Hudson Taylor Mission, China Inland Mission, when she went to Bible college, she found it was very difficult to find any place where there weren't people and distractions. So when I pray, I want to be thinking about God and thinking about the burdens of my heart. I don't need all the distractions going on. Well, at Moody, she finally found a place where she could pray and not be distracted. And she found the cleaning closet where they kept the cleaning supplies. And she would go in there and turn a bucket upside down, you know, that they scrubbed with. And she would sit on the bucket with the door shut. And in that little cleaning closet, she had her place of prayer, a quiet place where she'd be less distracted as she was talking to God. So that is what we call basic prayer. The Lord bends down to hear your prayer. And Jesus said, when you pray. And the third thing is a little subject on prayer that Jesus gave to us. And that was this. This is in Matthew 7:7-8. And he's talking about effective prayer. He says, when you pray, keep on asking, and you'll receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking, and you will find. Keep on knocking, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asketh receives, everyone who seeks finds, and everyone who knocks, the door will be opened unto you. A question that often people ask when they're starting to develop a prayer life is, how do I know? You know, do I just pray over and over and over about something? When can I let go of it? You know, I am seeking and I'm knocking on the throne room, and I'm wanting God to answer this prayer. So in the years past, people had an interesting saying, and they called it praying through. When I heard that as a new Christian, I had no idea what they were talking about. It was very significant, really, but I didn't understand what praying through meant. So if you are praying for somebody or praying about a situation, and how do you know when to stop seeking, knocking, and asking? The key there is when the burden is lifted. You no longer have that burden. You may have some prayer things that you want to talk to God about that may be on your prayer list or on your heart for a long time, because the burden is still there. But when you're praying and you know you've laid it before the throne of God, and God has it, and God will give you an inner peace, just a real inner peace, that you can let go of it and leave it there. Because many times our prayers are not answered immediately. They may take time. It may be years. George Mueller, a man of God that really believed in faith and in trusting God, ran orphanages in England. And George Mueller, I believe, had 50 men that he was praying for their salvation. And when he died, only 45 of them had come to the Lord. After he died, the last five came to Christ. See, prayer is taking our heart burdens and laying them at the feet of the Lord. And the Lord can give us assurance that we don't have to keep praying. But there may be some people that will be on your prayer list for many years. That's up to the Lord. But you keep seeking, you keep knocking, you keep asking. And if God gives you peace, then you know that the answer's on its way. We used to sing a chorus, you know, the answer is on the way. And so I can rest in that. I don't know when God's going to answer. There may be many type of circumstances he's going to have to arrange in the life of the person that we are praying for. But God hears. God said to pray, and God answers prayer. Know that. That's why we pray. May the Lord bless you as you begin a prayer journey, a life of crying out to God and praying. This is just section one. There are two more sections to go.